Hello kids, I hope all of you are doing well, all of you are healthy and all of you are safe. And I also hope that you enjoyed the previous class where we studied about the first lesson for class 5, that was The Owls in the Family by Ruskin Bond. Now today we will be doing certain exercises related to the same chapter. Why these exercises? Because they are helpful in understanding the certain terminology that has been used in the same chapter, where we have compound words. Now, what are compound words? They are words that are formed with two or more existing words combined together. For instance, we have examples like bird bath, rain plus water, rainwater, house plus hold, household, night plus bird is equals to night bird, black plus board is equals to blackbird. Now you notice that there are certain words like bird bath, rainwater, household and night bird that have been used in this chapter. Hence these exercises are important. So let's give a quick recap to the chapter that we had learned before we move on to doing this exercise. So the chapter began with the narrator and the grandfather finding two of the owlets lying in the veranda of their house. One day one owlet was found, the other day the next owlet. When they realized that the rainwater pipe was there on the roof. Now rainwater is a compound word. Then they took the two owlets, fed them well, took care of them, and they became happy. The owlets became happy living with the narrator and the grandfather. We also see that the mother owl was concerned about her little ones, and to make sure they were well fed, they had their tummies full, she even tucked a little mouse with its tail into the mosquito net. Then we see that after 10 days, the narrator and the grandfather at sunrise, at dawn, decided to let the birds free. So they tried to place them into a mango tree. But the mother owl was suspicious as to what the narrator and the grandfather were doing. Hence, she tried to attack both of them. And then when she saw that narrator and grandfather were at a distance, she took both the owlets into the tall grass. The next day when the narrator woke up, he saw that the two owlets were sitting on the wall of the house gate. And the mother owl, where was she sitting? She was sitting on the bird bath, right? And watching from there as to how the narrator and grandfather receives the owlets back into their house, because she knew that they were taken care of more appropriately in the narrator's house than she could have given, right? So she became an unselfish mother. We also learned that grandmother was not very happy with the pets they had. She was not very easy to please, but she developed the fondness towards these owlets, and the owlets also loved her back. So they had sweet memories that the narrator talked about of sitting on the rocking chair and looking at the owlets, plus how the owlet snuggled its head into the pillow of the grandmother and they snored in the sleep. So hope you remember the chapter. Now coming back to compound words, we see that rainwater was one word that I used while explaining the recap of the chapter, and bird bath was another. Now owls are also not night birds. Bats are is also what we've discussed. Hence, compound words are words that are made up of two or more existing words. Bird bath, rainwater, household, night bird and blackboard. Similarly, I have given you one small match the column that you have to do. Match the column to get compound words that are animal names. Earth, worm, rattle, snake, dragon, fly, grass, hopper and so on. So you have to do these 8 as a part of this worksheet, which is the exercises to the first lesson. Let's move on to the next question. Birds have feathers, wings, beaks, and they lay eggs. There are around 10,000 different species of birds in the world. The chicken is the most common species found. Now, this is just a small brief on what birds are and how many species of birds are available to us in this world, and which is the most common species of bird that is found. Now, related to this, you have to make a chart from A to Z and write down each alphabet indicating the name of a bird or any characteristic that is related to the bird. Draw an A to Z chart of birds. You can include name of birds as well as words associated with birds. Either the name of the birds you have to use or any words associated with birds. For instance, N, nightingale. N is also for nest. For example, A, you can use arctic tern. For B, you can use bulbul or beak. Similarly, for C, you can use a claw, that is the hand of the bird. For F, you can use feathers, or you can also use the name of any bird that comes to your mind. So you have to draw up a chart from A to Z and do the painful. I hope you all have understood what is to be done here. Let's move on to the third question. That is anagrams. Now, what are anagrams? Anagram is a word formed by rearranging the letters of another word. So, for instance, one word is given to you, that is listen. Now, the word listen has 6 letters in it. You have to rearrange these 6 letters and create a new word. Here we have silent. Similarly, for greet, you have egret. For heart, if you replace or rearrange the words that are the letters that are there in the word heart, you will get earth. When you rearrange the letters in the word race, you get care. For scent, it will be nest. For bake, it will be beak. Why these words? Because you have to form words related to birds by rearranging the letters of the words below. Now, there are 8 words that have been provided to you. You have to rearrange them and make a word that is related to the bird family. I have given you 2 examples, that is, for scent, it will be nest, for beak, it will be beak, and so on. So, this is the work, that the assignment that you have to do this time in this class. Apart from the exercises that we have done today, that is the compound words, the anagrams, and to the A to Z chart that you have to create regarding the birds, we have a set of 20 words that you have to learn as a part of your dictation test. That is for lesson number 1. Let me read out those words for you. We have clacked, threatening, appearance, persuade, tapping, inquiring, entrance, crooned, gurgled, swooped, stooping, agile, behavior, shrieks, snuggled, terrified, affection, infested, purring, and perch. And as far as the meaning goes, perch means a wooden bar on which the birds sit. Purring is a sound that a cat makes when it is petted. Infested, full of, for instance, when we talk about this chapter, the kitchen was infested with beetles, right? Affection is love for somebody that you have. Terrified, scared. Snuggled is to get warm or to get cozy with someone, shrieks, loud, sharp noises or sounds one makes, behavior is the way you present yourself to someone. Agile is fast or quick. Stooping is to bend down. Swooped is to fly over. Gurgled is yet another term wherein it's a sound of contentment that the owl makes. Croon is a sound of inquiry that a owl makes. Here we see that the mother owl was making the croon and the gurgling sound for her owlets. Then we have entrance is a place from where you start or you enter. For instance, the house gates are the entrances to our house. Then we have inquiring, that is when you have a lot of questions in mind, when you want to know answers to a lot of questions is inquiry. Tapping is knock something or make something move. Persuade is to make sure that somebody listens to you or is in accomplice to whatever you are saying. Then appearance, the way you look. Threatening is again scary. And clacked is another sound, shrieking sound that the owlet make. So these are the 20 words that you have to learn in addition to the three questions for the exercises that I have given you, that are compound words, A to Z chart on the name of the birds or related terms, and the anagrams, that is rearranging of the words in order to form a new word in relation to the bird family. Hope this chapter is good enough for you. The rest that are make sentences, antonyms, and the question answers we will be doing in class when we meet in school. So we will keep that aside for this time. And in the next class that we have, we will be reading a beautiful poem. I'll just give you the hint or the name of the poem, that is the books that we will be taking up in the next class. Hope all of you are safe and all of you stay healthy. See you in the next class.